If you love the fuzziness of the world's two most beautiful, special fuzzy northern breed dogs, but you can't decide which dog to get, Yeti and I will provide a good breakdown of their good points and their great points. Samoyed versus Alaskan Malamute, up next on Yeti's Place. For Samoyed ownership tips and tricks and breed comparisons, be sure to subscribe and click that bell. Samoyeds and Alaskan Malamutes were bred for similar purposes. They were bred to pull heavy sleds loaded with wood, timber, hauling supplies, building supplies, and other types of equipment. Both breeds are known for their power, their athletic ability, and their substance, not to mention their great beauty. They haul heavy sleds over a long distance at a moderate speed. When they finish up, they're sleepy like this guy. They face the most extreme weather conditions. Their thick, beautiful double coats are made to withstand the harshest of all temperatures. They both have thick, wiry outer coats. Their inner coats are soft, dense, and woolly. They have curly tails which look like plumes. Samoyeds and Alaska Malamutes both really don't like very hot weather. They prefer the brutal cold. They have similar exercise needs. Alaska Malamutes are one of the oldest breeds of dogs, dating back 2,000 years. They were first bred by the Malamute tribe as an important means of transportation. They carried light and heavy loads via sled. They assisted in the 1896 Gold Rush and various polar expeditions. In World War II, they worked as search and rescue dogs, and the breed was first recognized by the AKC in 1935. Samoyeds, like Yeti right here, are a true northern breed working dog. They were used in Siberia to hunt and herd reindeer and haul sleds. The Samoyed tribesmen, who were peaceful nomads, treated Samis as members of their family. They allowed them to live inside with them and their children, and these dogs would curl right up next to their owners, oftentimes acting as an owner's blanket. Samoyeds therefore developed a deep love of humans with an unfailing sense of trust and loyalty, and the breed still holds true to that to this very day. They are a child's best friend and most loyal playmate. The first American Samoyed was imported from Russia. They were registered with the AKC in 1906. And despite their Arctic heritage, Samis adapted to warmer weather. They can tolerate the heat of Florida, Texas, California, and even Arizona with great ease, with air conditioning. The Alaskan Malamute has a thick double coat of different color variations. The Malamute's eyes, like a Samoyed's, are dark and shiny. A Malamute has a dominant streak over other dogs. They have a strong prey drive with other animals such as squirrels, bunnies, and cats. Because of their strong prey drive, it's important that they always stay on a leash. But they can get along with cats as long as you have both your cat sitting near you as well as your Alaskan Malamute on a leash and you introduce them to one another as a pet. Then your Malamute might understand that cat as a pet, but still should be supervised. And they do have to be raised from a young age with a cat. Then they will know to understand the cat is a pet and therefore should not be attacked. A Malamute's lifespan is 12 to 14 years. Male's height is 25 to 28 inches tall. Females are 23 to 26 inches tall. For their weight, the males weigh 85 to 100 pounds and the females weigh 75 to 80 pounds, which is bigger than Yeti. The Samoyed. They were necessary for the survival of the Inuit people. They lived along the Arctic coasts from Alaska to Greenland. The length of their coat, color, and markings depend on the region where they originated. Now Samis, like Yeti, have long, thick, beautiful double coats of white fur tinged with silver. In the sunlight, they sparkle brilliantly. The males weigh 51 to 65 pounds, and Yeti is actually a little bit bigger than that. He weighs 69 to 70 pounds. When he's sitting up here, you can't tell how big he is, because when a Sammy lays down, it's like an accordion. They kind of shrink up very easily. Females weigh 35 to 55 pounds. Their lifespan is 12 to 13 years. Their temperament is extremely stubborn. They're very intelligent, lively, playful, sociable, and alert. And did I mention, they're stubborn. Sammies are a little bit longer than they are tall. They have a strong muscular body, built of speed and endurance. And oh my goodness, that endurance is incredible. They're strongly independent dogs who were bred to herd reindeer and protect their owners from wolves in the wild. They taught their young this independence and responsibility. And that responsibility still stays with them to this very day. A Sami's sense of reasoning is very strong, and it's still exhibited right here with this guy. Malamutes need a lot of exercise, and we're talking 1.5 to 2 hours every day. And by exercise, I mean a lot of exercise. That is a strong, hearty breed of dog. They can bowl extremely heavy loads of 3,300 pounds, which is over 1 ton. That equals about 1,500 kilograms. The activities they excel at are agility classes, doggy backpack hiking, bike shoring, which is pulling someone on a bike, sled shoring, which is pulling someone on a sled, skate shoring, ski shoring, karting, basically pulling stuff, including pulling lazy humans. Alaskan Malamutes are fantastic modes of transportation. They would distract polar bears for hunters. They would locate seal breathing holes in the ice, the coastal ice, along the North American and Atlantic seacoasts. They're very active dogs, and therefore they're not very good listeners. They too have an independent streak. They're not good apartment dwellers. They're quite active diggers. Build a sandbox for your Alaskan Malamute to dig. Malamutes don't like fences, and they will dig underneath that fence. They will escape if not properly entertained and given a lot of exercise. If you see to it that all of their exercise needs are being met, well, then you won't have a problem. Both Alaskan Malamutes and Samoyeds need an owner who's a firm leader. Neither dog is an ideal dog for a first-time dog owner, unless you're willing and able to put in a lot of work. Both breeds are extremely intelligent dogs and very stubborn. They are difficult dogs to train. If they sense that you're not a good leader, then they won't listen to you. Instead, they will happily do whatever they want to do. But with proper training, they will learn to follow your lead. You should start obedience training from a young age, and you'll learn how to manage your sometimes unruly Sami or Alaskan Malamute. Now, you do have to respect the mind of both breeds of dogs, in particular a Samoyed. Samoyeds have their own minds, and when you hold that respect, your Samoyed will return it with patience and love. When training a Samoyed, you have to give a command and make sure that that command is obeyed. Samoyeds will often joyfully meet the challenge of being trained. Give a command as an enjoyable, fun game. Praise highly the moment the command is obeyed, even if it wasn't done the way that you wanted. Now, Samis get jealous easily. They get jealous of other people paying attention to their people. They get jealous of other dogs and other pets paying attention to their people. They just get jealous easily. Samoyeds really want our attention, and they'll do whatever to get our attention. Love a Samoyed like a family member. Share your home, bring them for rides in the car, bring them on walks, bring them if you go to the ice cream store, bring them wherever you are. If you're in the bathroom, if you're in the kitchen, make sure that your Samoyed is with you regardless of wherever you go, and your dog will adore you. You'll help build the highly intelligent and friendly nature of a Samoyed by doing that. You'll enjoy being owned by a Samoyed. Like the Samoyed, an Alaskan Malamute also has a strong pact instinct. They too want to be included with their family. They love being around people, and they don't want to be left alone for greater than 3 to 4 hours of time. If they're left alone for that amount of time, they will cry, dig, and destroy your house. So don't leave them alone if you can't be there with them for 3 to 4 hours. They're not a good watchdog, neither is a Samoyed, just due to their friendliness toward other people and visitors, guests. They love everyone. An Alaskan Malamute also really loves children. They're patient and affectionate with kids, even when the child is climbing all over this big, beautiful, gorgeous dog. An Alaskan Malamute is often better with older children, just simply because the size of a young child compared to the big size of an Alaskan Malamute, there's a giant size difference there, and your Alaskan Malamute may get a little bit excited, and with its tail and its friendly nature, might accidentally knock a child over without meaning to. So older children are preferable to a younger child with an Alaskan Malamute just because of that excitable nature. Always supervise interactions between an Alaskan Malamute and a child of any age. Malamutes, like the Samoyed, are very sensitive dogs to changes in heat. Never ever shave the coat of either breed. Their coats protect them from the heat and the sun's rays. And with an Alaskan Malamute especially, you do have to make sure that you have air conditioning, because without air conditioning, that dog will suffer immensely. Alaskan Malamutes don't do well if the temperature is greater than 70 degrees Fahrenheit or 21 degrees Celsius. It's too warm for them to do a strenuous outdoor activity. In the summertime, be sure to provide plenty of shade and a lot of water for your Alaskan Malamute. Don't leave them outside for too long. Like the Sammy, you want to walk them in the early morning and then late afternoon, evening hours. And bring plenty of water along with you so that you can stop frequently and give them water. And make sure that you walk along a shaded area. Avoid exercise during the warmest times of day. Now, both breeds shed epically 365 days a year, and on leap years, it's 366 days a year. Each breed blows their coat twice a year. And by blowing their coat, I mean, check out this video. You'll have a dog-sized pile of fur. Brush them daily to minimize those giant, huge, massive clumps of fur while they're coat blowing. Use heavy-duty combs and a few different types of brushes. Now, when they're not blowing their coats, they still shed quite a bit. So be sure to brush them a few times a week. That helps remove their dead undercoat, and it keeps them comfortable. An Alaskan Malamute has a double thick coat, and they have an undercoat. It's about 1 to 2 inches thick, and it's oily and woolly. Due to the oil in their coat, a Malamute does need to be bathed a few times a year. Now, Samiads also have an extremely long, thick coat. Their undercoat is about 2 to 3 inches long, and it feels really soft, like cashmere. It has zero oil. Now, despite being hypoallergenic, a Samiad's long, thick coat drags in everything from outside. Tonight, Yeti and I were out on a walk, and he was racing into every single bit of shrubbery along the way and getting leaves, pollen, dander stuck in his coat that I'm still pulling out. The Samiad's outer coat is really long, about 8 to 10 inches long, sometimes even longer. And that's to protect them from the harsh Arctic climate where they originated. Samiads, even though they have this gorgeous white coat, it's a dirt repellent coat. Because the moment that dirt dries, it falls right off of them. It's like they're stain repellent. Therefore, a Samiad doesn't need that many baths. Last time Yeti was bathed was probably over a year ago. Thank goodness for that, because their fur epically clogs a bathroom drain. If you enjoyed this breed comparison, be sure to check out this one, and we'll bark at you next time.